In part 5 of our lesson on trigonometric functions of acute angles, you will learn how to solve right triangles using SohCahToa and the special angles. In this example, we have to find the exact values of x and y. So remember, any time we have a right triangle, we can use SohCahToa. And we have to look at the triangle and see what parts we have. Relative to the 30-degree angle that we are given, side x would be the opposite leg. The side 12 would be the adjacent leg. So if we're using opposite leg and adjacent leg, that means we're using tangent. So we know that the tangent of an angle is going to equal the opposite leg divided by the adjacent leg. In our case, we have tangent of 30 degrees is going to equal x, which we said is the opposite leg, divided by 12, which is the adjacent leg. Now remember that y could never be an adjacent leg because y is not a leg. Y is the hypotenuse. Now using our special angle chart, we go to the tangent row and the 30 degree column, and we see that the tangent of 30 is equal to radical 3 over 3. So we replace that in our equation and set it equal to x over 12. To solve for x, we just need to cross multiply the 12. So we have radical 3 over 3 times 12 is equal to x, and the 3 in the denominator will cancel with that 12 in the numerator to become a 4, and we find out that x is equal to 4 radical 3. Now to find y, we go back to our picture. Here's the 30 degrees. We know that 12 is the adjacent leg. We know that y is the hypotenuse. So if we're using adjacent and hypotenuse, we're going to use the cosine function. Cosine of theta is equal to the adjacent leg divided by the hypotenuse. And now we can fill in here. We get that cosine of 30 degrees is going to have to equal 12 divided by y. Because remember, 12 is the adjacent leg, y is the hypotenuse. Referring to our special angle chart, we see that the cosine of 30 degrees is equal to radical 3 divided by 2, and that has to equal 12 over y. Next, we will cross multiply the y up to the left hand side, and we can multiply both sides by the reciprocal of radical 3 over 2, so that's going to be 2 over radical 3. So now y is equal to 24 divided by radical 3, and we have to rationalize that. So we'll multiply by 1 in the form of radical 3 over radical 3. We get that y is 24 radical 3 over 3, which means that y is equal to 8 radical 3 once we reduce. In this example, we have to find the exact values of P, Q, and R. And we see once again, we have right triangles in the picture, which means we get to use SohCahToa. We always have to start out looking at the given angle, which is 45. The 6 is the opposite leg. We see that letter P is the adjacent leg. So if we're using opposite leg and adjacent leg, that means we are using the tangent function. Tangent of an angle, theta, is going to equal the opposite leg divided by the adjacent leg. And now in our case, we have tangent of 45 degrees. The opposite leg is 6. The adjacent leg is P. Looking at our special angle chart, we see that the tangent of 45 degrees is equal to 1, so we set that equal to 6 over P. All we need to do is cross multiply the P up, and we get P is equal to 6. Next, we can use the 45 degrees, we can use the opposite leg being 6, and the hypotenuse is Q. Remember, we know this is the hypotenuse because it is opposite of the right angle. So if we're using opposite leg and hypotenuse, that means we are using the sine function. And the sine of any angle, theta, is going to be the opposite leg divided by the hypotenuse. In our case, we have the sine of 45 degrees is going to equal 6 divided by Q. Referencing our special angle chart, we see that the sine of 45 degrees is equal to radical 2 over 2, and we set that equal to 6 over Q. We can cross multiply the Q up to the left-hand side, and we will multiply by the reciprocal of rad 2 over 2, so that means we have to take 6 times 2 over rad 2. We get Q is equal to 12 divided by radical 2. Now we will need to rationalize this. So we will multiply by 1 in the form of radical 2 over itself. We get Q is equal to 12 radical 2 over 2, which reduces to 6 radical 2. Now to find letter R, we're going to need to use the value that we just got for Q, which is 6 radical 2, so we can label that in our picture. For the 60 degree angle, R is the adjacent leg, and Q, which is our 6 radical 2, is the hypotenuse because it's opposite this right angle over here. So if we're using the adjacent leg and the hypotenuse, we know that we are going to use the cosine function, and the cosine of any angle is equal to the adjacent leg divided by the hypotenuse. In our case, we have the cosine of 60 degrees has to equal R divided by 6 radical 2. referencing our special angle chart, we see that the cosine of 60 degrees is 1/2. We set that equal to r divided by 6 radical 2. To get the r by itself, we just need to cross multiply up the 6 radical 2 to the left-hand side. So we get 1/2 times 6 radical 2 is equal to r, and 1/2 of 6 is 3, so we get that r is equal to 3 radical 2.